Any nausea?
Yeah. Bit of a headache, too.
On a scale of 1 to 10?
Tequila hangover or something like that.
8 weeks. And none of us suspected anything. Did she give you any indication at all where she was headed? Anything you might have overlooked?
Not that I could think of.
I'll get this to the lab, sir.
I'd like some samples sent to my lab as well as quickly as possible.
Any luck running that call that came into my cell phone?
All we know is that it was made from a Manhattan payphone at 12:21 a.m. There's no way of knowing who placed it.
John, it seems that Olivia was able to cross over momentarily, but unable to stay here.
Well, we gotta get her back. So how do we get over there, Walter?
Crossing over is out of the question. Not without Olivia's help. But there may be something I haven't thought of yet.
Peter, you said she administered the paralytic at 2:15 a.m. Now, what were you doing there at 2:15 a.m.?
Well, Olivia called our house. She thought she heard someone trying to enter her apartment.
Well, of course, you don't have to cover for me. Since we came back from over there, Olivia and I became something more than friends.
I see.
It's perfectly understandable, son. In the 70s, I innocently wandered into the wrong home, and it was 3 days before I realized my mistake. And unlike Olivia, the woman with whom I was sharing a bed didn't look like my wife at all.
She took the wrong computer.
I was searching her computer last night, and she caught me, but I convinced her that it was mine.
What's on it?
I don't know. It was encrypted.
Hernandez, I want access to every file on this computer.